Hi guys, this is Jordy from Seido. Today I would like to talk to you, introduce you about engraving. Laser engraving is a very interesting work. It's about the wood itself, craftsmanship, how the wood would behave with the laser itself. It's about computer science, it's about hard science, it's about a lot of things. So I will try to show you today in this video everything we do here. I would like to mention that here we, for equipment as well as for everything we do, embroidery, engraving and everything, we are always looking for the best quality available on the market. So for the laser engraving machine, we heard that one of the best company, the most renowned company in the world, is a French company called Gravotech. So we imported the machine directly from France to Japan. And we had it a little customized. We opened each side of the machine to have enough space to put the bokken and jaw and everything we engrave in it. We made a lot of adjustments to the machine itself to improve the quality and the workflow. And I'm going to try to show you that in this video. So let's go.
Here is the engraving machine. It is quite small, but big enough for 40 cm wide engraving. We had the two side panels open, allowing the weapons to be fitted into the machine. Here is the software. I already have a lot of presets on my screen for each type of fonts and size we offer. Automatic positioning is possible, but I feel more comfortable adapting the positioning for each engraving for a better result. In the software, I only put the content of each engraving I want to perform. Luckily, I have a logo engraving to perform today. Here it is. The engraving is for a hard ebony bokken, so it is not possible to work on different levels of gray. The logo received from the customer was quite small, so I already enhanced the quality. Now I will just make it black and white and delete the Japanese letters as requested by the customer. Then I just have to resize to the size needed for the bokken handle.
So, here is the spot where I'm working. You have the machine on the left, the computer on the right. You see that what I set up before is already on the screen, since we're going to start with this engraving right away. Here is the machine itself, so you can see that it has a cover with a radiation protection for the laser. A few buttons here, but it's mainly controlled by computer. What we will control here is the position of the laser and red dot pointer to find the right spot where to start the engraving. It's pretty simple here. Everything is in the computer.
All minor settings are already preset, so I will only adapt those that depend on the wood. Speed and power of the laser. These settings determine the depth and the burn effect of the engraving and must be adapted to the wood you are working on. I also do some minor adjustments based on my appreciation of the wood of a specific bokken. Then I put the bokken into the machine and now I am positioning the laser using the red dot. The grid below the weapon, but also the laser movements, will help me finding the alignment. Once positioned, I will set the focal distance between the laser and the weapon. And here the engraving starts. The masking tape allows to place some guides as well as it prevents burn traces around the engraving. Let's move the camera to the left panel so we can zoom in. Slow motion. Then fast motion to the end of the engraving. and here is the result. Now the logo. Logo engraving is a bit more complicated, so I already run some tests and made the presets. I am just checking that everything is correctly set before sending the data to the machine. And here we are again, into the machine. Ebony is a hardwood with traces of metals that makes the laser reflect and burn the air around the engraving, so I have activated the integrated blower. And here we have our logo. Let's fast forward the part where I check again the bokken and the engravings before sending it to packaging.
So, as you can see, it's not that easy to have a good engraving even with a computer-guided engraving machine. It's a combination of everything I like, all my passions. It's about the wood itself, how the craftsman selected the wood, the humidity in the wood, how it will behave depending on the power of the laser. It's also about hard science, about computer science, how to use the software, how to set up the laser. It's about focal lengths. It's about a lot of hard science stuff. And as you know, here at Seido, we make our own website to sell a very traditional handmade 100% made in Japan equipment. So it's a very good definition of Japan. It's a combination of tradition and modernity. And it's like everything we do here at Seido. I hope I could give you a part of my passion in this video. And if you liked it, you can just leave a comment below in the comment section, or you can just click on thumbs up or subscribe to the YouTube channel. I hope we will see you soon for another video on our channel. Thank you very much for watching and see you soon.